Round two of this Legacy League with Elves. This time I get to be on the play, which of course is huge with any Legacy deck, but particularly with a deck that has a lot of speed and not a lot of interaction like Elves, you really want to be on the play. This hand's great as well. You'll notice a theme that most hands that have Gaia's Cradle and another mana-producing land are extremely, extremely good with Elves. We'll lead with Nettle Sentinel. So I guess that means the cat's out of the bag on turn one. My opponent knows exactly, you know, probably 58 of the 60 cards in my deck as soon as I play Bayou Nettle Sentinel, but that's fine. Delver. Okay, so Delver decks are usually close but favorable matchups for Elves, so I really enjoy playing them, and having a good draw on the play in game one is just a fantastic start. Now, this is going to be another case where I definitely want to play a creature before I play the Cradle. I have to worry a little bit about Daze here. So I think what I should do is play Gaia's Cradle and then Birchlore Rangers and see what my opponent does. Now, if this resolves, I can tap the two. Well, I can tap the Cradle for two mana, play Glimpse. Then I tap these two for second mana, play Nettle Sentinel, floating one, then tap two. So if I brick on my Glimpse draw, then it actually doesn't go that well for me. Like if I just draw land, let's say. Instead I could just go for natural order this turn and win the game if my opponent doesn't have Daze or Force of Will, but playing into a Daze like that is not my favorite idea either. So in other words, I could tap these two, play Nettle Sentinel, untap, tap these two and Cradle for four mana, and then play Natural Order. Yeah, this turn is unfortunate because I don't have any plays that go great around against Daze. I could also just play Reclamation Sage and pass the turn, or, you know, attack with Nettle Sentinel. And then that sets me up next turn for a lot of great plays, although it also sets my opponent up to potentially wasteland my Gaia's Cradle. I think maybe I should just start with the Glimpse. The upside is so high if I do draw one mana creature with my first draw step, plus my opponent might just choose to Force of Will. Usually better to cast the Glimpses earlier, because if you're waiting on them, that also means you have to wait and save up creatures in your hand, when a lot of times you want to just play the Glimpse, maybe they Force of Will, and then either way you can just dump your hand on the table and find a way to win from there. So my opponent, I think, probably has either Daze or Force of Will or both. And it's always really challenging from the Delver side, too, to decide when to pull the trigger on those cards. Elves makes a lot of mana, so sometimes you can't catch the card you want to catch with a Daze, but in a Glimpse of Nature turn, every mana really matters. So the question of, like, when do you make them spend the extra mana is a very important one, and I think my opponent's going to think pretty hard about this. If my opponent has Force of Will, I think this Glimpse earns a Force of Will because I have access to a lot of mana and could easily just run away with the game if he or she lets it resolve. It's good for me either way. The worst case scenario is that it resolves, I cast Nettle Sentinel, and I draw either a land or another natural order, something like that. Wow, Force of Will pitching days, so my opponent actually had both. And I think this is a good, safe way to play the game from my opponent's perspective, so I can support that. And now, I guess the only thing I could really do is play out the second Nettle Sentinel. I can attack, and then hopefully my opponent does not wasteland the cradle. The Delver versus Elves matchup is also really interesting because you can sometimes just win a fair and square fight with creatures. Like if the opponent happens to not draw Tarmogoyf, then the Delver deck doesn't have a lot that can really hold off the Elf Onslaught. My opponent's going to have a good turn here with a Lightning Bolt and a Wasteland, so really, really cutting my amount of mana. And now I'm going to have to get a little bit lucky if I want to keep doing my thing this game. Wirewood Symbiote. Okay, so that's a fine draw. I think my best bet is to cast it and then attack with both Nettle Sentinels. Another wasteland cuts me to no mana. It's unfortunate. Now, if I draw a land, what happens? If I don't draw a land, what happens? These are good things to think about before I just rush to untapping. I don't think there's any reason to use the symbiote now, though. Quarian Ranger, so that's going to be extremely good when I do find a land. For now, I'll just get in for one. No reason to rush things. No reason to take my Nettle Sentinels off the table. And I still don't know what variety of Delver deck my opponent's playing. Could be Temur Delver, could be Grixis Delver, could be just a straight red, blue-red burn-heavy version. And note that this is not a good race for me. However, if I draw a land and can start untapping the Nettle Sentinels every turn, then it becomes a lot better. Yeah, this is getting ugly. I think this is going to be probably my last opportunity to draw land and actually have a chance in this game. Well, I guess if my opponent has nothing, I can draw land next turn and go crazy with the Heritage Druid and the double Nettle Sentinel. So it's hard to tell if my opponent is actually just a blue-red deck or is intentionally not fetching the third color to try to fool me. Guy's Cradle's best draw in my deck. Now I actually have a shot here. Seems to me like the first thing I should do is cast Heritage Druid, and my opponent's probably going to have to Force of Will that or Lightning Bolt to Nettle Sentinel in response, but even that's not that bad for me. Is there anything else I can do? Is there any way I can play this where I'm not leaving Heritage Druid open to a Lightning Bolt? I don't think so. I think I just have to play Gaia's Cradle Heritage Druid. And remember, if my opponent casts Force of Will, I can attack for 5, making the fetch land unusable, making extra copies of Force of Will unusable. So Force of Will pitching Spell Pierce. Yep. So I'm countered. And now I want to cast Elvish Visionary. I guess there's nothing else I can really do. And hope that my opponent doesn't have or find a Lightning Bolt. All right. So I actually won that game just with the Gaia's Cradle draw on the last turn. Perfect. It would have been a little unnerving if I had lost that game because my hand was very, very good and I was on the play in what I usually consider to be a good matchup. But thankfully I do get the job done. So anyway, the sideboarding against Delver is fairly minimal. I like bringing in two Abrupt Decays, the Scavenging Ooze, Progenitus over one of the Crater Hoofs. And then Reclamation Sage is a pretty easy cut, but beyond that, pretty much just making small trims like a Heritage Druid and a Nettle Sentinel, maybe. Llanowar Elves, not stellar either. Sometimes I bring in one Thoughtseize, but I don't think that's a really good card. I think you want to just focus on your own game plan. Could also. I know some people are less into natural order, but as long as I'm bringing in Progenitus, I think I want to have all the natural orders. But I could see a plan where you go to like only one Crater Hoof and one natural order or something like that. But yeah, I'm gonna go with this, just fairly minimal changes. One subtle reason why Thoughtseize and Abrupt Decay are not as good as you might think is they often force you to fetch a Bayou where you would rather go for basic forest in the early turns. List hand's good. I mean, I don't have any action, but it has a lot of mana, which is the number one. That's basically rule number one with any deck against Delver is you don't want to be light on mana. You want to make sure they can't mana screw you and then let the rest fall into place. So I think I play Forest and Llanowar Elves here. I can see playing a Bayou trying to induce the opponent to Wasteland. That's probably a bit too fancy, though. Yeah. And I'm fine playing Llanowar Elves first because I don't have to worry about getting 2-for-1 by a Forked Bolt. Okay, Daze. That's a really good one to be revealed to the Delver so I can know about it. Dismember. Still have yet to see a second color, by the way. And the fact that my opponent used Dismember indicates that he or she probably doesn't have Lightning Bolt or much more removal. A card that's definitely going to be on my radar here is Rough Tumble. All right. So against the Daze, my options are not really that great. I think what I want to do is play... I mean, I wonder if I just make my opponent use the Daze. Yeah, it seems like I want to play Bayou, Deathrite Shaman, and then Quarian Ranger. Make my opponent use the Daze. Yeah. Sure. Next turn, I can start with Glimpse of Nature, which will probably earn a Force of Will if my opponent has one. And if not, I can at least draw a couple cards off the Wirewood Symbiote. And either way, the goal is to draw out some counterspells and clear the way for a natural order the following turn. And I have to say I've drawn extremely well in this game. Remember that my complaint about the opening hand was not having business, and then my first two draws were Natural Order and Glimpse of Nature. Pretty good. And I like that I've been able to play the game so far to not leave my Gaia's Cradle open to Wasteland. Okay, another Delver. So now all I really have to worry about is Force of Will and Daze, and I have a lot of mana to play around the Daze. Now, I could just go for Natural Order before anything else. Like Wirewood Symbiote, Gaia's Cradle for 2 mana, activate the Deathrite Shaman, that's 4. Go for Natural Order, get Progenitus, win the game, but... I don't really want to play right into a Daze like that. I would rather lead with Glimpse of Nature. And I have to worry less and less about Daze because my opponent just shuffled after a brainstorm, so this late in the game... he or she may have chosen to not leave the Daze in hand. Okay, Force of Will counters the Glimpse. That's fine. Now the way should be clear for Natural Order next turn. So here I'm just going to play Wirewood Symbiote and then pass with Deathrite Shaman mana open, probably to gain myself 2 life. Spell Snare. All right, well, I don't have any 2-mana spells in my hand. I don't think Spell Snare is a very good card to have post-board against Elves. I guess it can't be that bad, though, because you can always pitch it to Force of Will. Let's gain some life, please. All right. Well, I think I'm going to attack with Wirewood Symbiote. Then I'm going to play Gaia's Cradle, tap the Cradle and my 2 forests, and Natural Order sacrificing the Symbiote, and try to put Progenitus into play. Again, I could go for the win here by cracking Dryad Arbor, and then Natural Ordering for Craterhoof Behemoth. Would that even be lethal? That wouldn't even be lethal. Plus, I'd have stifle to worry about. I think it's just better to get Progenitus. I know one of my opponent's cards is Spell Snare. I have enough mana to pay for Spell Pierce. So I just have to worry about Force of Will. And even against a Force of Will, I'm not completely dead in the water because I can keep gaining a bit of life off the Deathrite Shaman and see one or two more draw steps. And here we go. Okay, so my opponent's last card is Spell Snare, which I know from the Delver flip, only one card in hand. So I think my best play here is to exile a spell to put my opponent at 10 and try to win the game via attacking with Progenitus next turn. Seems a bit greedy from my opponent's perspective. If he or she had just killed the Deathrite Shaman main phase, then I wouldn't have had enough mana to cast. Well, actually, that's not true. I could just Verdant Catacombs and sack the Symbiote. Ponder, okay. My opponent needs to find a way to gain life or deal me 4 damage here, which I don't think either of those cards exist for blue or red mana. All right. 2-0 with Elves.